Leafs are the home team, so they get the last change. Auston Matthews is out with Andreas Johnsson and Kasperi Kapanen against Noel Achari, Chris Wagner, and Joakim Nordstrom. A line that had an excellent game number two, as most of the Bruins did and were underway in Toronto. Marner got the puck, threw it towards the net. McAvoy's there to clear it. Here's Marchand looking for some help at center. Spins off a check from Marner, tried to anyway, and then got knocked down. Maple Leafs get the puck back. Tavares and Marchand are tied up in front of the Leaf bench as the puck is dumped in and Marlowe stays on it. Knock the puck loose. Nylander's in front of the net. Centering pass was tipped. In comes Riley. Shoots, and that's stopped by Tuukka Rask. What action now. Puck's knocked out of the air. Riley gets it at the blue line. Put it to the side of the net. Nylander trying to protect the puck as he goes up the boards and turns, and he fanned as he tried to dump the puck back in and has to retreat to center. Bruins are changing. Top line is coming on. Marchand is there. Pasternak in front of the net. Stopped by Anderson. Tried to slide it underneath him, and Frederick said no from the blue line. McAvoy's shot. That deflected away from the front of the net. Marchand to the blue line. Another hard shot and another great save. Anderson on McAvoy.
Oh, Anderson following up the way game two went. He lost the game, but he was the best player for the Maple Leafs. Frustrated at times, the Bruins. Pasternak, watch the patience by Pasternak here. Tries to sell that he's going to go upstairs to get Anderson to lift his leg, and then
took the face off. Krejci trying to get out through center's turn back. Carlo following. On the other side, here's Jake DeBrusk driving it on Riley. Takes the shot. Anderson steered to the side. Puck comes out to Carlo. Ripped the shot off the post. Charlie Coyle helped him out, and the Bruins get to center. Could be a two-on-one here. Coyle back is with a shot. There's a rebound that's knocked away from Anderson, who's been ever so sharp early on. Frederick Coche back the other way. A little chip and chase. He gets to the puck. Ennis stays on the puck, battling here. Fourth line against fourth line. Krug lost the puck at his feet. Ennis took it back to the front of the net. Tip just wide by Gauthier. Riley to the net. Last made the save. Rebound. Score. Trevor Moore. In his first ever playoff series, Trevor Moore gets his first NHL playoff goal, and Toronto has struck first.
And the value of your role players. You look for a fourth line energy shift, an offensive zone faceoff against the defense pairing of Krug and Carlo. If nothing else, you're just trying to get them to wear them out. Instead, a hard forecheck, a couple of turnovers, and just as I said earlier, get the puck to the net to create second chances. And that little tip by Moore on that initial shot from Riley.
Tyler Ennis gets the other. There's a steal by Marner, and his shot just missed the net. Jake Muzzin holds the puck in. Marner off the boards against Bergeron. Great little turn back. Works to the front of the net. Tavares with a shot. Hit the side of the net off the glove of Rask. And many sitting behind that goal thought the puck was in the net, but it was on the net. In comes Carson Kuhlman. DeBrusk gets there, trying to center for David Krejci. Walks up, put the puck on net. Anderson the save. Rebound. Score! David Krejci ties the game 1-1.
Well, how similar are these two teams when they have success? Get in on the forecheck, create a loose puck to create a chance. A long stretch pass that all you're trying to do is chip it in to get it in deep. Haynes, he tries to hold up for his partner. In quickly is DeBrusk. He's got help there and a rebound that Anderson unable to help, and Krejci has good hands, able to bat this one out of midair. There's the deflection, not once but twice, a bouncing puck, and Krejci just gets enough of it.
Marchand put the puck into the middle, trying to spin off a check. Jake Muzzin broke up a play, gets the puck to center. Marner puts it in. Tavares wide open in front of the net. Deep stop, and the net is off as momentum carried Tavares right into the goaltender Tuukka Rask, who made the save and is still in the back of the net. Power play is brought to you by the all-new Ram 1500 Motor Trends 2019 Truck of the Year. Morgan Riley with the puck, his shot over top of the net. Tavares had to duck out of the way. Johnsson, Matthews shoots, he scores! Auston Matthews Blues has statistically entered this series 12 seconds into the power play. 2-1 Toronto.
And a failed clearing attempt. You know, faceoff's so important. The Leafs keep control. There's a chance to get the puck out by Bergeron. Marner makes the initial play, and then how about Johnson? Just froze the goalie for a split second. He's in the slot. You have to respect a shot might come. And a quick little release there by Matthews gets it past the goaltender before.
Matthews got the puck back. Johnson in for Tavares. Good reach there by Carlo, and he got the puck to the line, but not out. Johnson, here's Matthews up against Brandon Carlo. Tavares centering. Johnson backhander scores! To back power play goals, and the Maple Leafs in game three have a 3-1 lead.
And it's pressure again that creates a turnover. Carlo can't get the puck out of the line. You've got he and Kampfer. Now Chara had just had a long shift, so he's sitting on the bench. Kampfer and Carlo get stuck in the corner. The play is made out front. You can see John Tavares between his legs, past the outstretched stick of Bergeron, and how about the hands in tight as Johnsson pulled it to his backhand, got it up and over.
They'll stay on the outside here. Krejci has Heinen in the corner. He gives him the puck. Coyle's working in front of the net. Krejci, one-timer by Grizzly, just wide. The rebound, there's a shot, they score. Charlie Coyle got it after Heinen missed it at the side of the net. The Bruins get a power play goal and pull back to within one.
And this missed shot was by design. As you mentioned, one guy missed it in tight in Heinen, and you got another one, Coyle, who was backing him up. Play down low to go back to the side, and watch this shot. This is on purpose wide to try to create a rebound. Dermott tries to get in, and that's maybe the reason why Hyman wasn't able to get to it. Dermott did a pretty good job of tying up Hyman, but right behind him with a down on his face Anderson after that rebound.
Zaitsev's got a little time up the boards and out. Chara pumped by Hyman, and the fans love that as the big man goes down. Tavares got the puck. Hyman goes wide against the forward, cuts in front, stopped by Rask. Big save there. That was David Pastrnak, who was back and got Brandon Carlo. Skated into traffic at center. Marlowe took the puck away. Heinen took it from him. He's got Coyle with him. The centering pass off the stick of Coyle. Quick shot by Backes as Coyle set him up. And Anderson makes the save. Kampfer. Here's Kuhlman. Grizzlick was right there with him. Kuhlman down, up, DeBrusque, centering pass. Krejci went to his backhand, and the puck was poked away. Anderson with a big save. Leafs desperately trying to clear the puck, and now they'll get it out. Patrick Marleau to center. Dumps the puck in, and they'll change again as the clock gets to 3 minutes. Big battle in front of the net. DeBrusque is getting position there, or trying to. Pastrnak into the crowd. Tipped wide of the net. Zaitsev. Banned on that, it went up the boards. Krug trying to center, can't. Here's Brad Marchand, back to the line. Pastrnak fakes, over to Krejci, to Pastrnak, fires a shot, big block. Two big blocks by Mitch Marner, and that's it. The Maple Leafs win game three, 3-2. Ha ha.